Dear friends, welcome you all for this evening worship service. Indeed, it is a great joy to come together and worship God. This is the 10th Sunday after Trinity. I am pleased to share with you that this worship will be led by the respective women of our Gurukul community. I thank our women faculty members for organizing this worship together with other sisters from the campus. The preacher for this evening is Mrs. Lily Jayakumar. She is the wife of Dr. Arvind Jayakumar, professor of Old Testament. She belongs to the Methodist Church in India. Academically, she has BBA and MBA degrees. She had served in different IT companies over 8 years and has served in different capacities at Leonard Theological College, Jabalpur. She also had served in the Anita Methodist School, Chennai. She and Dr. Arvind are blessed with two nice children, Alfred Lemmy and Judith Vivian. We welcome you again to join this worship and praise God together in spirit and in truth. God bless all of us.
Dear sisters and brothers, as we come into God's presence this evening, let us glorify and lift the name of our God. Let us celebrate the unique gifts that God has given to each woman, each man, and every girl and every boy. Let us celebrate the independence that God has given to each of us, as we have just celebrated 74th Independence Day. Let us come together to give thanks for the call to be like Christ and to follow Jesus into a broken world to repair it. Let us worship the Lord with gratitude.
Let us worship God by singing the Kannada Bhajan. Saranam, Saranam. The meaning of the bhajan goes like this. We take refuge in you, O love personified. We take refuge in you, O divine light and embodiment of mercy. We take refuge in you, O giver of life, eternal light and giver of peace.
Let us sing together, this is the day that the Lord has made. people of God. God is faithful in giving us yet another opportunity to worship and thank God for all things in our lives. God of Eve, God of Sarah, God of Rebecca, and God of all people, we want to thank you, God, bringing in our sacrifices of worship. Let us sing together with our hands lifted up and our mouths filled with praise. Lord is in our hearts, we will sing like Mary sang.
Make it.
let us receive the assurance of forgiveness. May the God of love, God of forgiveness and compassion, forgive us as we have repented and clean us and help us to reconcile with God, with each other and within self, and strengthen us to transform ourselves in her image.
Amen.
The Old Testament reading is taken from the book of Genesis chapter 18 verses 1 to 8. Genesis chapter 18 verses 1 to 8. And the Lord appeared to him by the oaks of Mamre as he sat at the door of his tent in the heat of the day. He lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, three men stood in front of him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them and bowed himself to the earth and said, My Lord, if I have found favor in your sight, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought and wash your feet and rest yourself under the tree while I fetch a morsel of bread that you may refresh yourself, and after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant. So they said, Do as you have said. And Abraham hastened into the tent to Sarah and said, Make ready quickly three measures of fine meal, knead it and make cakes. And Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to the servant who hastened to prepare it. Then he took curds and milk and the calf which he had prepared and set it before them. And he stood by them under the tree while they ate. Here ends the reading.
Gospel reading is taken from Luke chapter 16 verses 19 to 31. There was a rich man who was dressed in purple and fine linen and who feasted sumptuously every day. And at his gate lay a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who longed to satisfy his hunger with what fell from the rich man's table. Even the dogs would come and lick his sores. The poor man died and was carried away by the angels to be with Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried. In Hades, where he was being tormented, he looked up and saw Abraham far away with Lazarus by his side. He called out, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am in agony in these flames. But Abraham said, Child, remember that during your lifetime you received your good things, and Lazarus in like manner evil things. But now he is comforted here, and you are in agony. Besides all this, between you and us, a great chasm has been fixed, so that those who might want to pass from here to you cannot do so, and no one can cross from here to us. He said, Then, Father, I beg you to send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, and he may warn them so that they will not also come into this place of torment. Abraham replied, They have Moses and the prophets. They should listen to them. He said, No, Father Abraham, but if someone goes to them from the dead, they will repent. He said to him, If they do not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they be convinced even if someone rises from the dead. Here ends the reading. Praise be to God.
Greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I thank God for enabling me to stand before you to preach God's word. I am neither a theologian nor a pastor, but as a believer, I would like to share a few thoughts from the passage that has been read to us.
At this moment, I would also like to thank our principal and the chaplain for giving me this opportunity and for encouraging me to stand before you. Before meditating the word of God, let us look to the Lord in prayer. God, speak to us through your Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hospitality can be defined as the friendly and generous reception and entertainment of guests, visitor, or strangers, which can be witnessed in almost all the cultures of the world. Moreover, the different cultures of India pay the highest respect to the guest and value hospitality. In fact, traditionally, it is understood that guests are considered as God's own reflection. Like elsewhere, Tamil culture also gives importance to welcoming guests and treating them well, taking care of the needs such as food and accommodation. And it is well reflected in the classical Tamil literature, Thirukkural, where a separate chapter has been dedicated to discuss about hospitality under the title Virundombal, meaning hospitality. One of the verses of this chapter says, Selvirundu ombi varuvirundu paathirupan nalvirundu vanadavarku. Selvirundu ombi varuvirundu paathirupan nalvirundu vanadavarku. Which means, the one who treats and takes care of his guest and waits to receive new guest will be welcomed as special guest in heaven. Similarly, hospitality is a constant and consistent theme in the Bible, to which we have many references. For example, in the Old Testament, the people of Israel were often reminded about their experience of slavery in Egypt and were commanded to be hospitable to others, Leviticus 19:34. At the same time, in the New Testament, the early church believers were encouraged to show hospitality to one another without grumbling, 1 Peter 4:9. Hence, it is clear from the Bible that hospitality is one of the significant virtues of Christianity, and we are invited to be hospitable to others. Therefore, I have entitled my short reflection for this evening as Christian Hospitality. Genesis 18 chapter records the story of Abraham and Sarah's generous hospitality to the three visitors who came to them by the oaks of Mamre. Whenever the theme hospitality is discussed among the ancient Israelites, this action of Abraham and Sarah is cited again and again. Let us be hospitable to others like our ancestors Abraham and Sarah has become a proverb in the later days. The same thing is also mentioned in Hebrews 13:2. Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing that, some have entertained angels without knowing it. But my dear friends, what uniqueness one can find in Abraham and Sarah's hospitable treatment shown to the strangers who visited them. When we carefully read the chosen passage, that is Genesis 18 chapter, especially from the verses 1 to 8, three unique qualities can be identified from Abraham and Sarah's hospitality. First, Abraham volunteered himself to show hospitality to strangers, which is from Genesis 18, 1 to 3. The first three verses of Genesis 18 says that the Lord appeared to Abraham by the oaks of Mamre. When Abraham saw three men standing near him, he ran from his tent entrance and met them and bowed down to the ground and said, "My Lord, if I find favor with you, do not pass by your servant." This welcoming action of Abraham reveals two things. Number one, he volunteered to show hospitality to strangers. That is, he did not wait, rather he rushed to greet his visitors. And the second thing is, he was not aware that he is offering hospitality to the Lord. That is, without any expectation, he welcomed the strangers without realizing the Lord is visiting him. Further, Abraham was not bothered about who these strangers are, or he was not suspecting by thinking, will they harm me and my family if I invite them? Without having all these prejudices, Abraham welcomed the strangers wholeheartedly and volunteered himself to show hospitality to them. Because sometimes welcoming unknown people in our midst may eventually be a threat to our life and existence. This understanding which exists today was also prevailing during the time of Abraham. But the people of Israel understood hospitality in the following way. That is, in the processing of showing hospitality, the host should play a vital role by minimizing or totally removing the total fear and threat by creating a friendly atmosphere. Or that even if the stranger or the unknown person who has a plan to harm the host might change his or her intention. This is what Abraham did. That is why Abraham's attitude towards the stranger was regarded as a typical example for hospitality among the people of Israel. Abraham was ready to welcome the unknown guest in the midst. Secondly, Abraham was willing to take up a humble act of service. This is chapter Genesis 18:4. In verse 4 of Genesis 18, Abraham says, "Let a little water be brought and wash your feet and rest yourself under the tree." By saying so, Abraham is going to the next level in his act of showing hospitality to the strangers. He was ready to serve the strangers to any extent. Although the first phrase, "let a little water be brought," appears in passive voice, which indicates that Abraham will order his servants to offer water, but still, his concern to help the stranger reveals his attitude of taking up an act of humble service, even though he was a wealthy and prominent man. This unique character of Abraham elevated his reputation among the early Israelites. In fact, Abraham was a prosperous man with abundance of wealth and many servants to assist him. However, he did not command his servants to serve the strangers. Instead, he took the initiative of serving them personally through his humble gesture. Thirdly, Abraham, Sarah, and his servant treated the strangers incredibly as if they were kings. Until this moment, Abraham, Sarah, and his servants were not aware of the real identity of the strangers who were welcomed in this midst. Genesis chapter 18 verses 5 to 8. The third unique quality of Abraham's hospitality is mentioned in verses 5 to 8. Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to the servant who hurried to prepare it. Then he took curds and milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them, that is, for his unknown visitors. And he stood by them under the tree while they ate. Abraham is personally taking the responsibility of preparing delicious food for his guest. He engaged his family to join with him in treating his guest. He gave different tasks to his servant and his wife, and as a team they prepared food for the strangers, and Abraham placed the dishes before his guests and he stood by them as they were eating. These events, one after the other, highlight the personal interest shown by Abraham in treating his unknown guest. As I mentioned earlier, being a rich person who had numerous servants, Abraham did not order his servants to treat the stranger. Instead, he went forward to welcome them and gave them a place to rest and treated them with delicious dishes, which he himself served. With due respect, Abraham and Sarah treated their unknown guests as if they were kings. Through their hospitality to the strangers, Abraham and Sarah received two miracles from God. The unknown guest who visited Abraham and Sarah were none other than God himself, which is actually an opportunity that many have not received. Therefore, God became the guest and Abraham and Sarah became God's host. Secondly, they were given the promise that a new guest will soon arrive in their family, that is, the birth of Isaac were predicted. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, the hospitality of Abraham and Sarah reveals the godly attitude that we should have towards the strangers. It is an example of accepting and welcoming those differences of someone whom we may or may not have met before. In the midst of the various crisis situations that we are undergoing due to COVID-19, God invites us to be good Samaritans. This is indeed the appropriate time and opportunity for us to exercise our Christian hospitable nature by expressing our concern towards the people who are in need and those who are not familiar to us, who live in hopeless conditions. Let us not spend our valuable time on researching of how COVID-19 had entered this world. Is it because of my sin or others' sin, or because of the sins of the entire world? Indeed, let us be hospitable through our words and deeds to the people who are infected and affected due to COVID-19. It is really sad that most of us are missing the worship service and fellowships, and we are eagerly waiting to have them again. But during this time of pandemic, we should become bearers of good news to the people who need encouragement and support to overcome this crisis situation. And as God is pleased in such hospitable attitudes from us, when we help the people who are in need and show our hospitality towards them, then actually we are welcoming God in our midst. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ displayed the qualities of Christian hospitality through his life, death, and resurrection. May the good Lord mold us to be God's instruments of peace and comfort in order to embrace, encourage, upliftment the strangers in and around us who are facing the worst consequences of COVID-19. God bless you all. Amen.
On behalf of all the members of Gurukul community, I take the pleasure to greet our friends who celebrated birthdays during this week. On the 11th, Pitala Vinod Kumar, BD2, celebrated his birthday. On the 14th, Swam Swarup from BD3 and Miss Maria Asunta, who is our office staff, celebrated their birthdays. On the 16th, Don Paul of MTH1 is celebrating his birthday. May God bless all these God's dear children and give them good health and life of witness. We say happy birthday to you. God bless you.
Let us intercede. God of the nations, we pray for India. We pray that you would safeguard our nation from those people and the structures that destroy peace, unity, and fraternity. We pray that you will guide political leaders of our nation. Give them the wisdom to deal justly, especially as the country is fighting with pandemic. Lord, in your mercy.
Gracious God, we pray for the churches, church leaders, and the pastors in India. Let them serve with humility, sincerity, love, and care. Let the church be a place where justice, peace, and love prevail, so that by serving you, the people will come to know of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers.
Lord, we pray for our Gurukul community, the governing council, the principal, and all the members of the faculty, the non-teaching staff, all the community members, and all the students, and all our family members. Grant your wisdom, grace, love, and peace, so that we may all live in peace, as the students will be writing their exams online. Grant their wisdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers.
Healing God, we commit the world that is fighting with coronavirus into your hands. Grant your healing, and let your peace prevail all over the world. We remember those who are hungry, those who are struggling for life, both physically and socially, those who are homeless, children who have no parents, the elderly, children, women and men, and transgender and all other vulnerable communities. Let your hand protect them from all dangers and evils. We remember the families who have lost their loved ones and those who are sick in our Gurukul family. We pray that your comfort and consolation would grant them peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Let us say Jesus' prayer according to our context. Our Mother and Father in heaven, blessed be your name. Your kingdom of fellowship and relationship come. Your wish for joy, peace, equality and harmony be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our sins if we forgive others. Lead us not into temptation of claiming our ego in the name of caste, class, gender, race, region, age, language and color, due to which the world is broken, but deliver us from all these sins. For yours is the kingdom, glory, forever and ever. Amen. God, your mother and your father, bless you to be a blessing, provide you to be a provider. God, your mother and your father, make one's own face shine upon you to bring shines on others' faces and be gracious unto you to be graceful. God, your mother and your father, lift up one's own endorsement upon you and give you peace so that you will be a peacemaker.